Hey everyone, Jim Baugh here with Jasper Engines and Transmissions, and today I'm with Josh Cobb. And Josh is an engineer with Jasper's new product development team, and today we're going to talk about tuners, and specifically this one right here. This is Jasper's HP RTD Plus tuner. And Josh, a customer, would receive a tuner like this whenever they would order a DOD delete engine so they can modify their vehicle's ECM. Talk about that.
Yep, that's correct, Jim. To briefly explain, if the vehicle was originally made with a DOD or cylinder deactivation of any type, the ECM or engine control module would be programmed to perform that function on the vehicle. Jasper offers a DOD delete option. It's a quality improved option for these applications. It offers replacement of the failure prone hard parts of the internal engine. In turn, we do have to send out a tuner so that the ECM or engine control module can be reprogrammed to accommodate those changes that we make.
So when an installer gets ready to do the modification process to the vehicle's ECM, what are they going to have to do to make that happen?
A good question, Jim. Currently, we have some step-by-step instructions. We send this flyer with every tuner that we send out. There's a QR code that you will scan under the applicable tuner that you have, and it will populate a step-by-step instruction for you. We are also going to do a quick video to add a little support for our customers if they would rather watch the process firsthand. So.
Great. Let's get started then.
Great.
Today we're going to be showing you how to tune your vehicle's ECM using Jasper's exclusive RTD Plus device from HP Tuners and their Tune Delivery Network application, also called TDN for short. Again, this is a smartphone application, so you will need a smartphone. You will also need a Wi-Fi connection or a good internet connection to work with this application. We're going to start by downloading the application on your phone and setting up your HP Tuners account. If you've already set up your HP Tuners account, you can go ahead and jump right to the read section of the video if you'd like. So we're going to start by going to your phone's app store. I am showing you with an Apple device, but it can be used with a Android device as well. So we're going to go down to the search. In the search bar, you'll type in TDN for Tune Delivery Network and select search. Select it and allow your application to download. It may require a username and password. I don't know how your device is set up. That'll be device by device. Okay, then we're going to go to open, and it should populate a thank you for downloading message. Scroll to the bottom and accept. Select okay, another thank you message. And now this window will pop up. It's trying to pair your RTD device with your phone right away. For what we're going to do here real quick, we're going to exit out, and we'll come back to this later. So we've exited out, and we're going to now go to set up your account. You're going to select the little figure there in the middle that says account, and this screen will populate. Username and password. As of now, you do not have one, so we're going to register a new account there in the middle. So it will take you to the HP Tuners website. You'll scroll down to the bottom and it says, don't have an account, question mark. And then in blue, it says, sign up now. You will click that link to take you to the account setup page. So use the email address you want for your account. And you'll select send code before you go any further. What this will do, it'll send you a verification code to that email. You will have to go to that email account, open up the email, and find your verification code, and enter it in the verification code field. Once you've done that, you'll select verify code. And once you've verified code, you can scroll down and enter the rest of your information for your account. Enter your password, name, and to make sure you're not a robot. And then select create account. Once your account is created, you can go back to your TDN application on your phone and enter your username, which is your email address, and your password, and select login. All right, now that you've logged in, you'll see your account name or your email address there along the count line. Right next to it, there's a little gear with an I for info. Go ahead and select on that. Entering this info only helps us find your name once you get the read file to us, so the more info, the better. You're going to look for your name, your shop's name, your email address, your phone number, address, website if you have one. Enter what you have, and then select Save Profile. So once you've selected login and you are logged in, you'll see your account name there along the top bar, and it will ask you for an invite code. In that invite code, that is the code that is on the sticker on the outside of the packaging that the RTD Plus device comes in. You need to enter that code and select Join. After you select Join, under the linked tuners, you'll see Jasper Engines and Transmissions. Before you enter that invite code, you will not be linked to Jasper Engines or any tuner. So once you read the vehicle, the tune basically doesn't go anywhere. So you do need a linked tuner to be able to do this. So again, enter the invite code on the outside of the packaging. It's also called a TDN code, I believe, on the sticker, and select Join to link you to the Jasper Engines account. Okay, now that you have the app downloaded, you've created your HP account, you've signed in, and you have Jasper Engines as your linked tuner, go to the Tools. Now we're going to sync your device, your phone, to your RTD device. So in the Tools menu, select RTD First Time Setup, and you're going to follow the prompts on the screen here. Select Next. Again, it's going to remind you that you need to have your Bluetooth turned on. It's just letting you know that the setup is going to go. Select Next. So plug in the RTD to your vehicle's OBD port and select Next. When you plugged it into the OBD port, it will turn green once it's powered up. Now for the Bluetooth connection, you're going to push the little square button under the letters BT on the device until it flashes blue, and then select Next. It will ask you if you want to pair, select Pair. So we're going to accept the pairing. We need to remove the RTD device from the OBD port, plug it back in, and when the light turns green, select Next. And then it will pair your phone to the RTD device. All right, it's letting you know that the setup is complete. You're going to select Done. And it may go into something like this, is connecting to the device. There may be some updates that it will do automatically for you. Just allow it to operate here. So that is completed. Your setup is done. Now your RTD device and your phone can interact together. Okay, once your RTD device and your phone are set up together, we can go to the flash icon. It's the lightning bolt there toward the middle, and you are going to select Read Vehicle. Again, it's going to prompt you to plug it in. If you have unplugged it for any reason, select OK. With the vehicle's key on, engine off, per the instructions. There's several pieces of information there. Now would be a good time to read and follow all prompts as it goes through. It's not uncommon for a lot of lights, bells, or the dingings to go on. That's normal as part of the read. It's not uncommon to happen. You can allow the read to complete fully. On many of these, there's more than one controller that it reads, so allow it to finish all of them before continuing, and follow any prompts the screen populates for you. So what's going on now? You've read all your modules. The RTD is retrieving them, sending it to your phone. You do need a good internet connection for this. That's the way that the tune is sent to your tuner, which is Jasper Engines. This is telling you your read is complete and that your tune has been sent to your tuner for them to complete your edit tune. Select OK. And again, that is the end of the read section. Okay, now that your read is complete, the next step is to sync your files. And basically, all that means is that you're going to retrieve the edited tune from Jasper. So select Sync Files at the bottom there. All right, you'll notice that now you've got a little green check mark there to the left. So select the vehicle you're working on there. You'll notice two tune files. The restore is also your read. So that's your original read tune from the vehicle. You will not select that one. You'll want to select the AFM delete, note write this tune. So click on that one, select write vehicle. And it's asking you to plug your RTD in again if you had to unplug it for any reason. Select OK. And now the write process will begin. And this is writing the edited tune to your ECM. And let all the processes complete. Follow any prompts that it asks you to do. Some may ask you to cycle the key at a given time. So again, any prompts, follow them as requested. All right. That write has completed. Select OK. That is the end of your tuning. You can unplug your RTD device, start, and drive the vehicle.
Well, thank you very much for your help there, Josh. It was very informative. And if you'd like to have more information on the remanufactured products of Jasper Engines and Transmissions, there's a couple of ways you can find that out. You can either log on to www.jasperengines.com, or you can give us a call, 800-827-7455. And that's all the time we have for this episode. For Josh Cobb, I'm Jim Ball, and we'll see you next time.